Today we're talking about South African nuclear war. Or, in a less clickbaity manner of speaking, the battle going on over whether South Africa should increase its nuclear budget. One of the key issues with nuclear energy is containment, but in South Africa the nuclear issue is seeping out and contaminating all sorts of sectors. For example, in a terrifying headline, "Oh man! Two words I never want to see together are nuclear and uncertainty. It's like morning class or Trump re-election." In this case, though, South Africa's nuclear program's unstable funding was a leading contributing factor to one of the main credit agencies downgrading their bonds to junk. And, last time I checked, junk still isn't a good investment. Although those comic books my mom said were junk are now part of her retirement plan. So, who knows? Back to the nuclear program, though. Because recently,
President Cyril Ramaphosa says the proposed nuclear build program will only be considered in the broad context of affordability.
On the context of affordability? That's political speak for, yeah, we'll consider it in the context of definitely not considering it. Because President Ramaphosa has also specifically said,
"We've got to look at where our economy is. We've got excess power right now, and we have no money."
Sounds like the perfect time to invest in an expensive energy program. So this is probably pretty close to the end of the conversation, right? Well, step in South African Energy Secretary Prime Minister Jeff Radebe.
The National Union of Mine Workers has threatened to withdraw its support for the ruling party, African National Congress. This follows the Department of Energy signing the hotly contested renewable energy agreements with 27 independent power producers.
Alright, so before we get into this agreement, I'd like to take a second to travel back to the days of President Zuma. You know, back before we considered things in the context of affordability, and more in the context of whether the Gupta family will make money off of this. And boy oh boy could they ever. They were a uranium supplier, which I've heard are a pretty crucial part to nuclear power. Ah, finally, a story in South Africa where Westerners aren't the bad guys. So let's go back to 2015.
Back to our top story. South Africa signing this massive nuclear deal with Russia.
Yes, that's right. We're talking corruption, Russia, and nuclear. If Trump had tweeted about this, this would be the clickbait bingo. So on December 9th, 2015, just hours before Finance Minister Nene was fired, President Zuma and his cabinet approved a 1.6 trillion rand, or $100 billion nuclear project, which, to put that cost into perspective, was about the entire South African budget that year. Now, like all reputable deals, this one was negotiated entirely in secret, which led to, in 2017,
the Western Cape High Court has set aside all nuclear deals with South Africa. The court ruled on Wednesday that all the deals were unlawful and unconstitutional. This includes deals with the United States, Russia, as well as South Korea.
Let me tell you how upside down this all is. The people suing the nuclear energy deal for being unconstitutional were the Earth-like Africa Johannesburg and the Southern African Faith Communities Environment Institute, who sound conspicuously like two groups that might like green energy, although nuclear energy might produce more waste than one of Zuma's budgets. Now, I read through the case brief on exactly what happened, which, for whatever reason, used the word gazetted so many times. I think someone needs to get those justices a thesaurus. Basically, the problem was that these intergovernmental agreements, or IGAs, were set to be discussed before Parliament, and before they did, they were tabled, and therefore happened without any agreement. What this means is that, congratulations, you guys are out of the 2015 deal with Russia, as well as an unrelated 1995 deal with the US and a 2010 deal with Korea that just kind of got lumped in there. So this led to the question of the day. If this deal happened in 2015 and then was abandoned in 2017, why are we talking about it today? Well, because you don't have to look too far behind to find yourself in a conversation where it must have been really awkward to ask for funding to any other type of energy. Hey Zuma, you know you're giving the entire yearly budget to expanding the nuclear energy sector. You wanna, on top of that, give a little to solar? In fact, the renewable energy budget dropped to about $4 million last year, which might have been less money than the government spent on Zuma. And this financing was down from the previous 7 years' annual spending of over $2 billion a year. So renewable energy projects were definitely not being renewed. A lot of renewable energy companies shut down their operations in South Africa and moved to other countries in Africa, most notably Morocco and Ethiopia. Things have changed though now that South Africa isn't going all in on nuclear. So back to the story we were talking about earlier.
Yesterday, Energy Minister Jeff Hadebe signed a 56 billion rand contract with 27 independent renewable energy producers. So the money has been waiting for 3 years or so. Patiently.
Don't worry though, nuclear enthusiasts, because the Department of Energy is maintaining that nuclear energy will stay in the picture. Although, I'm not sure if it's even in the periphery of the frame, because officials are saying that it will come under review again in 2023. So let's talk about this new renewable energy push in which Eskom, the state-owned utility company, was given the go-ahead to sign outstanding power purchase agreements with independent power producers from 3 years ago. So yes, under this new IPP agreement, Eskom is now buying energy from 27 additional renewable energy independent power producers. But not everyone's happy about that. In fact, the signing was delayed a week when the National Union of Metal Workers of South Africa filed an indictment because going green really benefits those who have green. Because South Africa uses coal to fulfill 77% of their energy needs, which, to put that in perspective, is 15% more than the percentage of all fossil fuels we use for power in the United States. And we're not exactly known for being good for the environment. The specific case here was that these charges could put at risk more than 30,000 jobs in the coal mining industry, with more on the chopping block if renewable energy trends spread. And as you can probably imagine, that isn't great for the economy. This is despite the fact that these new companies were selected on the merits of price and job creation. The other argument against it is that we have the value-added tax raising the prices on literally everything, so you don't want to go out. And the price of fuel is going up, so you can't go out. And now we're raising the price of electricity, so you can't stay in either. A partner at Mining and Energy Advisory, which, wow, I wonder if he has an agenda, said, demand had fallen to below 2007 levels, mainly because of a massive increase in electricity costs. And that was at a time when South Africa was blacking out more than, well, an American tourist on vacation in South Africa. On the other side though, you have the Department of Energy, which is saying, in a nutshell, these projects will provide 61,600 full-time jobs, of which 95% is for South African citizens. And good news for coal miners, those jobs are in construction. Minister Adebe also stressed that this will provide competition and diversification in the electricity marketplace, something that was clearly not a priority the previous administration, who put all their eggs in one nuclear basket and then borrowed eggs from other people to get that basket overflowing. Furthermore, we're seeing an immediate estimated 3.1% growth in GDP because of this, an amount of growth that the United States would put taxes in a paper shredder to try to achieve. You'll also have Minister Radebe and the Department of Energy saying, everything that the Steelworkers Union is saying is wrong, and renewable resources are actually going to bring the price of electricity down. One final piece to the puzzle, I need to mention that this is estimated to make an additional 25% of the electricity generated in South Africa renewable, which is not bad if you're viewing it as a side benefit, and amazing if you actually care about the environment. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video and want to support independent journalism researching South Africa. Slam that subscribe button if you do, and as always, thank you for watching.